So, Pap, when we broke, we were talking about the NSA stories over really over the past week and a half, which started, of course, with the revelations from Barton Gellman of the Washington Post that internal audits show that the NSA has overstepped their bounds, broken essentially the statutes, and who knows the Fourth Amendment of the Constitution, 2,000 times over the course of a 12-month period in just the out of their Fort Meade facility in 2012. Also, the story that the head judge of the FISA court says they don't have the ability to enjoin the NSA from doing anything because they don't have the ability to determine whether or not they're overstepping their bounds. And we also heard that the NSA was not reporting these violations, sending them to the heads of the intelligence committees. And then, of course, we recounted the story of Glenn Greenwald's partner being stopped for 9 hours in London and the Guardian having their computers smashed by the British government, all of which is just shows about the intimidation tactics that are being used here. There is no way they understand that they can maintain a state of secrecy in the size that they are by actually securing it. They have to intimidate people. And then,
well, Sam, you have insider after insider saying this is out of control. You have people that are resigning, that are saying, I'm not about all this. This is not what I signed up to do. And when you have that kind of stuff happening in the NSA, you know, something's up. I mean, you have a FISA judge saying, I don't know what they're doing. Understand, the FISA court was put together so we would know what they're doing.
Indeed.
And so you have a FISA judge saying, I have no idea what they're doing. We don't have any way of knowing what they're doing. There are no checks and balances. We don't have any way to even look into to find out if they're doing anything improper. And this is a pretty damn scary stuff. In the same story that we're following in Utah, they're building this monstrosity of an NSA organization. It's one of the biggest in the world. It's a massive data center,
and by all accounts, the only reason why you would need this is if you were storing not just the metadata but all the content of our phone calls. And in that context, Pap, and folks will not hear this on the corporate media, even the so-called liberal outlets, really. Barely, for the most part, cover this stuff. But, you know, one guy who sits on CNN, he writes for The New Yorker, Jeffrey Toobin.
There is
an attempt by the establishment in many respects to sort of to criminalize, demonize Edward Snowden. And as time goes on, we see the import of his leaks. We see that it really is, in all intents and purposes, whistleblowing. But I want to read a little bit from his piece because I want to get your reaction to this, Pap. He writes, he starts his piece off by saying the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. and Robert F. Kennedy led directly to the passage of a historic law, the Gun Control Act of 1968. Does that change your view of the assassinations? Should we be grateful for the death of these two men? Of course not. That's lunatic logic. But the same reasoning is now being applied to the actions of Edward Snowden. This is just an outrageous straw man.
Yeah.
I mean, we now know that that Edward Snowden's leaks and whistleblowing has led to multiple bills being presented by lawmakers. We have nearly seen the NSA surveillance virtually defunded, but for a vote of 12 members of the House. We are seeing the media raise its sensitivity to it. We are seeing the American public raise its sensitivity to it. And that is because we didn't know what was going on. We've seen it from Wyden and Udall in the Senate saying that secret law was being devised, but they couldn't tell us about it. This is just an outrage.
To answer your question, Toobin is just, he's just an extension of what we always talk about, corporate media. It used to be a day when they would do, they would cover this the same way that the Daniel Ellsberg story was covered, when the discussion by the journalist covering the story talked about how it's a protective mechanism for all of us. Go back and look at the way Ellsberg was handled. Ellsberg was handled, it was almost like, thank goodness somebody is giving us material. that we can report on. And yes, we will report on it. And yes, we will tell the story. But thank goodness that's happening. Now, jump over 40 years, and all of a sudden we see a media that this Tubin is exhibit A of corporate media now. They don't have any alliance. They have no alliance whatsoever with the average American. They are just, he's just a tool of corporate media. And corporate media, of course, is going to take a position on this. They'll do it more and more, that Snowden is the villain. Now, with some stations, it's because they're so owned by this administration that they're told this is the talking point. We hope you'll deliver it. And Tubin is exactly that.
Well, you know, by the end of his piece, he says there is obviously some legitimate debate to be had about the extent and legality of American surveillance operations. And the reality is that none of that debate took place. None of it could take place because you had senators who were basically hinting at this, but they were bound by secrecy not to say anything. The only reason why this debate is happening, the only reason why there are literally over a half a dozen bills in the House and the Senate to reform this system of surveillance in this country, the only reason why there was a vote to defund it, the only reason why you have media outlets, at least in print, talking about it, is because of Edward Snowden. Right. And people can take issue with how he tried to run away from the law, and leave this country. But you would be irrational that you would get a fair trial, Sam, in this context.
Yeah, don't miss this part of the story too. Okay, the part of the story where we understand that corporate media is at very best. I mean, if you give them the best outside ability, it is they can go after low-hanging fruit, okay? Now, what Snowden delivered to the American public is not low-hanging fruit. He had to do some digging. Now, media, if we still had a responsible investigative media, they could have found a lot of this on their own without Snowden. But they're dysfunctional. They are no longer in the business of reporting stories with the breadth of importance of what Snowden unveiled to the American public. They're incapable of that. They're dysfunctional. They're underfunded in the sense of the news department is no longer a news department. It's infotainment. Yep. So in comes Snowden, in comes Assange, WikiLeaks, this is their only source of information left.